of today's support group, I just want to say thank you so much for the turnout, for all of you for coming. I know some of you have travelled far, far away, but thank you so, so much. There are some questions from the email that myself and Priscilla made up, and Priscilla's really sorry that she can't be here as well, she's in Thailand. but yeah, without Priscilla, like, she really helped as well. So there was a couple of questions from the emails that patients wanted to know, and this is just for the sake of the video, about is it going to be recorded and will they get access? Yes, it's been recorded, and we will obviously send the link via the email, and it will also be on the Royal Free website. And I don't know about YouTube, I'll have to check, but I'll let you know. And there's also, oh sorry, was there a question? No. So another question was, I was wondering whether I would be able to access the presentation notes or video of the speakers, in particular by the presentation by Kim Winter. Once again, just email the patient support group email and we'll get on to Kim, and hopefully she'll give me her slides and I can send them on to you if you want that. And if there's anyone that would be willing to speak for future events, please let me know. That would be great. And what else do I have to say? As you can see, you've all got an evaluation sheet. Liz was kind enough to run upstairs and get more. So if you haven't got any, please come and find me. I've got some more here. Liz also brought down some of our cards. So you have our numbers and some Net Patient Foundation like sticks that has information about NETs if you want that as well. Also, our next meeting is going to be November, so it's going to be the 28th of November, which is a Tuesday, and it's going to be around the same time as today. It'd be great if you could all make it. Again, I know it's a Tuesday and you've got work and all the rest of it, but we're trying to do different days to try and please everybody. And there's also just one other thing that I was hoping to share with you. It's something that I'm working on at the minute, and I'd just like to get your feedback if that's okay. I'm currently doing my personal training on top of this, and I want to set up a kind of like a support group, but an exercise group, a fitness group, where I train cancer patients. And it helps them get stronger, help them fight fatigue. Obviously, I'll be doing some boxing and stuff in that as well, so help with any anger or stress issues you may have. It'd be for all ages. It's just an idea at the minute, and I'm still doing the course, but if anyone's interested, please, once again, email. Please let me know what you think, if it's a good idea, bad idea. I thought of a name called Fight It. Don't know how you feel about it. My dad thinks it's too aggressive. but just let me know. There's loads of research, if you were to look on the internet, about exercising cancers and how it can actually prevent and how it can help people with cancer. But it's just totally up to you what you think, if you think it's a good idea or not. And you can start here locally, maybe one day after work, and we can get a small groups together and see how you feel. But like I said, it's just an idea at the minute. All right? Has anyone got any other questions or anything that they'd like to know just before we end? Oh, yeah. This is the NetNatter group.
Yeah.
Yes, and this was one of the questions that I also wanted to clarify. Some people that do travel quite far away, like so this, we've got people in Bath and areas like that, there are local groups that are called NetNatter groups, and you can get them through the Net Patient Foundation. Now, Jane, and so sorry I've forgotten your name.
Bridget.
Sorry, Bridget, thank you. Setting up one in the North London, is it? North London area. So obviously we can liaise and we can get information about that. We can put that in our email. And I know Priscilla has made a timetable, I think, of different NetNata areas around the place and has put it on the NetPatient Foundation. So trust me, without Priscilla, this wouldn't be as good as it was today. Bridget was saying, if you want more, we're not involved in it at all. It's just patient-led only. And it's quite good, actually. Like, I've had loads of good feedback from other areas. So yeah, that's something else that you'd like to consider. Okay? Thank you so much for coming again. Thank you.